My role was a general called Perdiccas. He grew up with Alexander. They schooled together. They went to school with Aristotle. When Philip, his father, got killed, Alexander took over as the regent, brought his generals that were lower generals in the rankings up into being the foremost generals in his army. So Perdiccas went up into being the general of the infantry. Looked after all the foot soldiers. He was there prominent in all his campaigns, decorated, and there up until his deathbed, a close friend and companion. So he's a
It sounds like you really know this role. Did you do your own research too, or was this all in the script?
The script is so intense. It's an unbelievable script, and it is the best script. I mean, it's been 10 years in the making for Oliver getting this, so he's had a lot of time to work and hone, and he had some of the best people, the best historians working on the script with him to make sure it was tight. So the script is incredible, so you wouldn't need to do much more, but, you know, I did a lot of research, went to the British Museum where there's a whole exhibit on Alexander, read several books, Robin Lane Fox's book, the foremost one, and researched as much as you could, but a lot of the research happened symbiotically while you're actually doing the work. The way that it was shot and the group of people that we had was as close to we could get to the way that Alexander was, with his group of men fighting together, working together, drinking together, socializing together, campaigning, planning. So I got as close to it as I possibly could, I think. I mean, it has been told. They did it with the Richard Burton thing that was a bit of a flop and a bizarre film. I think the problem with its scale is that it is such an epic story and it's so big, a lot of people have been fearful to touch it. I mean, it's much like Troy. Troy is a huge story. And to try to tackle such an epic story that's in everyone's hearts and minds and try to contain it into a two and a half hour film, takes a lot of guts, and you have to be completely passionate about what you're doing, and you have to have a good crew and a good story and a good idea in place. So I think a lot of people have been fearful. I mean, the irony was the fact that there was Mel Gibson's Alexander, the miniseries, there was Baz Luhrmann's Alexander. A lot of people came out of the gate with the same idea at the same time, and Oliver beat them to the punch. This film was beating them to the punch and scared them away. And I think if any other film was made of Alexander, it'd still pale. This is the definitive one, I think. He's captured everything from harsh reality. It's not a beautiful, glorious Hollywood epic. It's dirty and it's real. You see the man for his brilliance and for his flaws, and I think that's the way it should have been told.
Thinking back on filming this, is there one day that really sticks out in your mind where you're like, this is the definitive moment of this film?
There was one day where we walked onto a set in Pinewood, and it was when Alexander has just defeated the Persians and we've taken over Babylon. And Babylon was the greatest city that's ever been created. And we've walked into this place, never seen it before. I mean, the direction that we got from Oliver was, we're rednecks who've just come back from the farm to see a city for the first time. And it's very true. He had skyscrapers, thousands of people, ticker tape parade. And we walk into this Babylonian palace. And the set was, it cost £5 million to make. Was incredible. Hand-carved doors, plants that have been imported with irrigation systems, a massive amount of people, there's maybe 700 extras, and standing on this huge, huge set with this glory around you, which is, this is incredible, this is mad. I mean, the scenes that we saw and the scenery that we saw in the three different countries that we shot in were amazing, but I think that one set kind of encapsulated everything. It was expensive, glorious, impressive, audacious. I'd love to, yeah, at the drop of a hat. The friends that I've made as a result of it, through all the guys that were in the movie and the crew and the cast, we're still good friends. Sort of went one of their weddings, we stay in contact all the time. So that alone would make me want to do it again. But although it was hard, every day was rewarding. You were coming back exhausted, having a pint with the guys, sitting down, drinking, discussing the day, and it's so surreal to think that you sat there in battle armor, scars, hair down to here, you're living a life that was, you know, 2,500 years ago. It was insane, and I'd love to.
Well,